Our lead story tonight, accusations again flew up and down Pennsylvania Avenue on the eighth day of the partial government shutdown. President Obama did raise the prospect of a short-term solution to address that and the coming debt limit, but Republicans weren't buying. NewsHour congressional correspondent Kwame Holman has our report.
I will sit down and work with anyone of any party.
President Obama came to the White House briefing room this afternoon to rebut Republican criticism that he's refused to negotiate.
I've shown myself willing to go more than halfway in these conversations. And if reasonable Republicans want to talk about these things again, I'm ready to head up to the Hill and try. I'll even spring for dinner again. But I'm not going to do it until the more extreme parts of the Republican Party stop forcing John Boehner to issue threats about our economy.
In fact, the president said he's even willing to discuss changes in the Health Care Act after Republicans agree to reopen the government and raise the national debt ceiling. He and House Speaker Boehner did get together by phone this morning, but reportedly mostly exchanged talking points. Shortly after Mr. Obama spoke this afternoon, Boehner came before the cameras with his answer. The president's position, he said, is unsustainable.
The long and short of it is there's going to be a negotiation here. We can't raise the debt ceiling without doing something about what's driving us to borrow more money and to live beyond our means. The idea that we should continue to spend money that we don't have and give the bill to our kids and our grandkids would be wrong. What the president said today was, if there's unconditional surrender by Republicans, he'll sit down and talk to us. That's not the way our government works.
Meanwhile, House Republicans say they'll call for a special bipartisan committee to work out fiscal issues and end the impasse. A similar group in 2011 tried and failed to reach agreement on deficit reduction, and the president today rejected trying that again.
The quorum is present.
And over in the Senate, Democrats made plans to offer a straight-up bill raising the debt ceiling. It faced a likely Republican filibuster.
The impasse in Washington did a number on the stock market again today. The Dow Jones Industrial Average dropped another 159 points to close at 14,776. The NASDAQ fell 75 points to close below 3695.